students, today I'm your Aishwarya ma'am and I'm going to teach you the chapter from your Beehive book, The Bond of Love. So before starting any chapter, that I always do is that we should talk about our author. Our author, our writer of The Bond of Love is Kenneth Anderson. Kenneth Anderson. Now who was Kenneth Anderson? Kenneth Anderson was an Indian-born British writer and hunter. So you see, he was a writer, along with that he was a hunter. So evidently he used to pen down his experiences of hunting, and this story is one of his experiences that we are going to read today, The Bond of Love. Now, what do you mean by the bond? Bond. What does bond mean? Bond means the strength of a relationship. The strength that a true relationship has. The attachment between two sides. In this story, we are going to see love is a blessing. Love is a blessing that is given to all of us, that is there within our heart. It is just that we need to pick inside our heart and seek that love within us. Love is a very delicate thing, and love is a blessing from God. We all are bestowed with. We all have been bestowed with the power to love. It is just our choices and our awakening that is love dependent upon. Love creates a bond. You see, love creates a strength, a bond between two sides, two different sides who love each other. We should keep our ways by loving people, by loving all the creations of God. In this story, we will see reciprocation of love from a wild animal. We consider wild animals to be wild and not capable of having any emotions. But in this story, we will see reciprocation of love from a wild animal, a sloth bear. Sloth bear called as Bruno, meaning brown, and an endearing name as Baba, with whom? For his human foster mother. That is our author, Kenneth Anderson's wife. So I will start from the beginning. How did the author get Bruno? Let us see, how did the author get Bruno? Bruno was rescued from the sugarcane fields of Mysore. People were chasing away wild pigs. Now gradually Bruno was gifted to his wife, and he started growing up in the house of the author, our writer and hunter, Kenneth Anderson. Now gradually Bruno started drinking milk. Now let us see what Bruno ate. Bruno literally ate everything. Bruno ate everything. Bruno drank everything. You know, he was a glutton, you can say, used to eat anything and everything. So you see, gradually he started drinking milk, then porridge. Let us see what all food items Bruno loved to eat. So porridge, and you see vegetables by a wild animal, a wild sloth bear. He ate fruits. Basically, the food of sloth bears are termites, okay? The insects, they have a long snout, you know, that is capable of having a high power of suction. So their snout reaches deep regions and takes out their food. So you see, he used to eat porridge, he used to eat vegetables, he used to eat fruits and nuts and meat, especially pork, curry with spices, irrespective of the spices or the condiments. With spices, he used to eat rice, irrespective of the chilies, bread, eggs, chocolates, sweets, pudding, ice cream, etc., etc., etc. Now, what he drank? Bruno drank everything. He used to drink milk and tea and coffee and lime juice and aerated water, buttermilk, beer, alcoholic liquor, and basically everything. So Bruno loved to eat as he was growing up with the family of the author and under the loving custody of his loving wife. So, because of this habit of consuming everything, Bruno once had a fatal accident. Actually, Bruno had accidents twice. You see, two accidents that befell on him. Let us see. This is very, very important. The first accident, Bruno consumed once barium carbonate. It is a poison. So Bruno consumed barium carbonate, which is a poison which the author kept in the library in order to prevent rats from library. It was meant for rats, and Bruno had the habit of, you know, eating everything and anything, and Bruno went inside the library and consumed barium carbonate. So naturally his condition worsened. He was not able to walk. He was not able to stand up. He somehow dragged his body outside, and the author's wife came to know that he had taken poison. And then what happened? Condition became critical. His condition became critical. He was rushed to the veterinary surgeon or to the vet for his treatment. He was getting paralyzed. Paralysis was setting on him. So he struggled to move. What were the symptoms? What were the conditions? He was vomiting. He was breathing heavily and with, you know, force. It was a difficult breath that he was taking. His condition was worsening. The vet is not habituated to treat wild sloth bears. So gradually he went through his book, the treatment for barium carbonate, and then he took out the syringe and the medicine. And there goes 10 cc of antidote. They waited. Nothing happened to Bruno. His condition was still worse. Again, another 10 cc, another 10 cc of antidote was given. Another 10 cc of antidote was given, and after 30 minutes, Bruno was able to walk and stand. And then gave a look of contempt, as if I am a big black sloth bear. What can happen to me? It's just, you know, a fluke. Nothing happened. So that was his expression. One more time. Bruno, what did he do? Let us see number two. Bruno consumed about 1 gallon of old engine oil. Bruno consumed 1 gallon of old engine oil from the Studebaker, from the sump means the pipe of a Studebaker. What is a Studebaker? An old model of an American car. So he drank old engine oil, about one gallon of engine oil from the Studebaker, from the old American car. So that oil was kept by author in order to prevent the inroad of termites. Bruno drank it, but luckily there was no ill effects of this consumption on Bruno like the previous time.